Hi, I'm Burke Holland.
And I'm Brian Holt.
And this is 5 magical ways that VS Code can work with Azure.
Magical.
Thing number 1, you can deploy your application directly from VS Code to app service like a scholar.
Like a scholar. So, Burke, I know you haven't deployed to app service from VS Code before, so I'm going to explain this to you very cautiously.
I have deployed from
app service. Not properly.
I've been doing it wrong?
Not like a scholar.
All right, walk me through it.
It's a couple steps here. It's actually pretty complicated, so I want you to put your thinking cap on.
All right, I'm listening.
Okay. First thing, get your smoking jacket on.
A smoking jacket? I don't know that I own a smoking jacket.
Well, you better get one if you want to deploy to app service.
This is a smoking jacket.
Smoking jacket? Okay.
It looks like just a regular jacket.
Well, one smokes in their smoking jacket.
Oh, okay.
Wouldn't expect you to understand. Okay. Smoking jacket's on, right?
I see.
Like a scholar, so we need to get scholarly.
All right, so what's step 2?
Step 2, gotta drink some scotch.
Of course. You only brought one glass?
Well, you're not deploying.
Was it a screw off top?
It's box scotch. Third step, drink your scotch. Fourth step. Just deploy to app service. You just right-click deploy.
Just right-click deploy. All of that's right-click deploy. And we should also note that you can also just right-click and set up continuous integration as well. So you could right-click and say set up deployment for GitHub or local Git. So.
Yeah, totally. It's actually super, super simple. You just right-click on there. There's all sorts of different options for it, and it goes straight to app service. So it's, it does auto-scaling for you. It does all these different features for you. So really, all you have to do is just say, I'm done with this project. My Node project, my Java project, whatever, and you just deploy it and it works.
Yeah, so you actually don't need a smoking jacket or scotch. You only need the app service extension. I will say though, if you have a smoking jacket and scotch and the app service extension, it's just even better.
Yeah, it makes a better experience.
It makes it better.
Yeah, it's actually in the documentation.
Can I have some scotch now?
Yeah, you can. Thank you.
Ooh, it's warm. Why is it warm?
Because it was in my car.
I feel good. Everything's going to be all right.
It just gets better.
Thing number 2, you can see and modify and work with data in Cosmos DB like you knew what you were doing with a database.
Like, this is why I love MongoDB, or Cosmos DB just in general. Like, I feel like an idiot when it comes to databases.
Same. Not a database person at all. But unfortunately, you gotta have one.
Right. Like, how many times have you had to, like, stand up, like, your own primary and secondary and replica set and clusters, and I've had to do it at least one too many times, which is exactly how many times I've had to do it.
Once is one too many times, exactly.
So this is why I'm a big fan of Cosmos DB just in general, is that you just say like, hey, I want to start writing things to the cloud and I just don't have to care what I'm doing.
Right, and you can use the Cosmos DB extension in VS Code, which you can find in the links below. And you can query your Cosmos DB with the Mongo API using Mongo Scrapbooks. You should actually query your database directly from your editor without having to leave the editor.
This is my favorite part, right?
Which is incredible.
I start like writing my code, I run it, and then I like write something out to the cloud, and then I can go in my editor, like in a different pane, I can see it like how I wrote it to it, and if it like messed up, I can like go fix it myself. I can delete it, I can modify it. It's
pretty cool. And a bonus for you Mongo people out there, you can use the Cosmos DB extension to connect to any Mongo database, so it actually doesn't have to be Cosmos DB, which is, I know exactly, it's because we love you. So you can check that out. That's the Cosmos DB extension for Visual Studio Code. Thing number 3, you can send messages from VS Code to Azure Event Hub, actually send and receive messages just like you were calling your mom.
Yep, just like everyone should be calling their mom.
You should be calling your mom, yeah, exactly.
Event Hub is this really cool service that Azure offers that allows you to send and receive messages, kind of like you do with like Kafka or RabbitMQ or one of those things.
Okay, message queue services.
Yeah, exactly. And you can send like, Cosmos messages to functions, and functions can send messages to your app service. It's, you can queue up all those kind of events.
So just a different way for all the different things in Azure to sort of talk to each other.
Exactly. And so what's cool about that is you can have all these things happening and you can manage that directly from VS Code.
Really? So, that's right, because there's an event grid plugin.
Yep.
Is that right?
Yep.
For VS Code?
Yep, exactly. And so you can plug into those, message queues, and you can see them come through. You can send new ones. You can do all sorts of stuff like that.
Directly from VS Code.
Directly from VS Code.
Does Event Grid chew you out if you don't call enough?
You know, that's the nice thing, as opposed to not calling your mom. If you don't call Event Grid, it doesn't do that.
Right, doesn't get on your case about it. Yeah. I'm gonna call your mom. I'm sorry. I know it's been a while, like 24 hours, too long.
Sorry, Burke's mom.
Yeah, I'm sorry, mom. Thing number four, you can create and deploy serverless functions with the Azure Functions extension, like you were a functioning human being.
I don't know what that's like.
No, neither do I, obviously. Drinking scotch in the middle of the day, this is not functional. You can download the Azure Functions extension for VS Code, which allows you to create, deploy, you can even debug serverless functions locally, and then deploy them directly to Azure Functions using the Functions extension.
This is like actually one of the things I do the most with Azure, and particularly with Functions and VS Code. It makes it so easy just to like create a new function, give it different bindings, different triggers, and all that kind of stuff. And you can test it right there in your editor, and it's just amazing.
Yeah, it's excellent. I use it probably more than any other extension as well. I'm not sure exactly why that is, but we both do that. I also like the fact that you can set application settings and basically manipulate your function without having to go to the portal, back to the editor, to the command line, back to the editor.
Right. I never look at the functions documentation, right? Like, that's amazing.
Right. Nobody reads the docs. There's only two types of documentation, the kind people don't read and the kind they complain about.
Yeah, exactly.
Thing number five. You can use VS Code to put stuff into Azure Storage and get it back out again like you were on an episode of Storage Wars.
It's my favorite TV show.
It's a great TV show. Did you see the episode where the guy bought one of the units and they opened it up and it was full of snakes?
Who bought that?
I don't know. I'm not joking. Somebody was breeding snakes in there, and apparently snakes can survive for a long time without food and water. The dude just got a unit full of snakes.
Actually, little-known fact, if you open the wrong Azure storage account, snakes come out of that,
right?
Too.
Snakes in the Cloud.
That is the great name for a new movie. It's the sequel to Snakes on a Plane, Snakes in the Cloud.
Samuel L. Jackson, Snakes in the Cloud.
So with the Azure storage extension, you can put basically any sort of like blob type file up in there. So you can put like PDFs, you can put like images, you can put
GIFs.
GIFs, very important.
Exactly.
That's actually what it's built for.
It was primarily optimized for GIFs, but you can put other stuff up there.
Well, it used to be called Azure Cat GIFs. And then we renamed it to Azure Storage.
So you can work with your storage directly from VS Code.
Yeah.
Instead of having to go somewhere else.
Yeah, to the portal or to some other thing, you can actually just start putting your assets directly in there from VS Code. It's pretty
right,
cool.
Which is powerful. I think what I've learned in working with all these extensions is that having your development assets in your development environment is where they really should be. I mean, context is everything.
Right, and it's like a short feedback loop, so you can just work and then manage all your infrastructure at the same time that you're working on the code.
So absolutely.
Really great.
It's as smooth as this scotch right here.
Cheers.
Segway. Oh, it burns so good. I'm Burke Collins.
And I'm Brian Holt.
No, you're not. You're Sarah Drasner.
No, I'm Brian Holt.
Okay. And now you know five magical ways that VS Code can work with Azure.